சொல்றாள் இல்லையோ, பீமா வாஸ் நாட் லைக் தட். ப்ரொபோர்ஷனல் டு ஈட்டிங் ஹி ஹேட் மெனி எக்ஸ்பிளாய்ட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ, அண்ட் தேர் ஃபோர் ஹீஸ் கிவன் அ பியூட்டிஃபுல் அப்ஜெக்டிவ் ஹியர், எ டைட்டில் ஹியர், பீம கர்மா, எ மேன் ஆஃப் டெர்பிள் டீட்ஸ். பீமா மீன்ஸ் பயங்கரா, கர்மா மீன்ஸ் டீட்ஸ் ஆர் எக்ஸ்பிளாய்ட்ஸ். ஸோ பீமானி பயங்கராணி கர்மாணி எஸ்ய சஹா பீம கர்மா. அண்ட் வாட் ஆர் ஹிஸ் பீம கர்மா? யூ கேன் ரீட் இன் மகாபாரத, சோ மெனி ராட்சசாஸ் ஆர் டிஸ்ட்ராய்ட். ஈவன் தோ ஹி ஹஸ் காட் வண்டர்ஃபுல் வெப்பன்ஸ், ஆஃபன் ஹி டசன்ட் யூஸ் எனி வெப்பன் அட் ஆல். எனி ட்ரீ அரவுண்ட் ஈஸ் இனஃப். எலக்ட்ரிக் போஸ்ட் இருந்தால் அதை எடுத்து அடிச்சுடுவார், கடச்சத்தை எல்லாம் எடுத்து. மவுண்டன்ஸ் ஹி லிஃப்ட்ஸ், ட்ரீஸ் ஹி லிஃப்ட், தேர்ஃபோர் ஹி இஸ் கால்டு பீம கர்ம. அண்ட் நேச்சுரலி ஹிஸ் கான்ச் ஷுட் நாட் பி அன் ஆர்டினரி ஒன். இஃப் யூ கிவ் அன் ஆர்டினரி ஸ்மால் கான்ச், அவர் ப்ளோ பண்ண கான்ச்சே உடந்து போயிடும். அண்ட் தேர்ஃபோர் ஹி ஷுட் ஹாவ் எ ஸ்பெஷல் கான்ச் ஆல்சோ. தேர்ஃபோர் இட் இஸ் கால்டு மகாசங்கம் பவுண்ட்ரம். ஹிஸ் கான்ச் இஸ் கால்டு பவுண்ட்ரா. பவுண்ட்ரா தி கிரேட், தி ஹியூஜ் கான்ச். அண்ட் ஹீ ப்ளூ தட் கான்ச். அண்ட் நாட் ஓன்லி தீஸ் பீப்புள், வியாசாச்சாரியா இஸ் நாட் சாட்டிஸ்ஃபைட், ஹீ மென்ஷன் சம் மோர் இன் தி ஃபாலோயிங் வேர்சஸ். அனந்த விஜயம் ராஜா குந்தி புத்ரோ யுதிஷ்டிரஹ நகுலஸ் சஹதேவஶ்ச சுகோஷமணி புஷ்பகௌ. யுதிஷ்டிரஹ அனந்த விஜயம் தத்மௌ. அகைன் யூ ஹேவ் டு சப்ளை தி வெர்ப் தத்மௌ. சோ யுதிஷ்டிர இஸ் அனதர் நேம் ஆஃப் தர்மபுத்ர. And he is called Yudhishthiraha because he is firm in warfare, very powerful. Yudhishthiraha, Yudhishthiraha. Yudhi means in battle. He is firm, he doesn't go back. Therefore, he is given the title Yudhishthiraha, and who happens to be Kunti Putraha, the son of Kunti. And who is Raja, the king? He blew the conch, Ananta Vidayam. Even the names are beautiful. Ananta Vidayam, which is ever successful. It brings him only success, never defeat. And Nakulaha Sahadevascha. Nakula and Sahadeva. So the other two Pandavas. சஹதேவா, இன் தமிழ் தேசே சஹாதேவன் சஹாதேவன் சொல்ற, பட் தி ரியல் வேர்ட் இன் சான்ஸ்கிரிட் இஸ் சஹதேவா. அண்ட் தே ப்ளூ தேர் கான்சியஸ், அண்ட் தே ஆல்சோ ஹாவ் பியூட்டிஃபுல் நேம்ஸ். வாட் ஆர் தே? சுகோஷ அண்ட் மணி புஷ்பக. சுகோஷ இஸ் தி கான்ச் ஆஃப் நகுல, அண்ட் மணி புஷ்பக இஸ் தி கான்ச் ஆஃப் சஹதேவ. காஷ்யஶ்ச பரமேஷ்வாஸஃ ஷிகண்டீ ச மஹாரதஃ த்ருஷ்டத்யும்னோ விராடஶ்ச சாத்யகிஶ்ச பராஜிதஃ த்ருபதோ த்ரௌபதேயாஶ்ச சர்வஶ ப்ருதிவீபதே ஸௌபத்ரஶ்ச மஹாபாஹுஃ ஶங்கான் தத்முஃ ப்ருதக் ப்ருதக். காஷ்யஹ Shankham Dadmau. Shankham Dadmau, we have to supply. Kashyaha is the king of Kashi. He is supposed to be very famous and very powerful. So the Kashi Raja, and who is a great archer, Parameshwasaha. Ishwasaha means bow. And Parameshwasaha means the one who has got a great bow, a powerful bow. He blew his conch. Shikhandi cha Maharathaha. Shikhandi, again you know the story, who is specially born, who has taken a vow to destroy Bhishma, and he succeeds in that also. And that Shikhandi is not an ordinary person, Maharathaha, the great warrior, the great archer, blew his conch. And Drishtadyumnaha, Drishtadyumna also blew his conch. Then Virataha, the king of Virata, Satyaki, and Aparajitaha. Aparajitaha means ever successful Satyaki. And not only these people, Drupadaha, the father of Draupadi, and Draupadeyaha, the five sons of Draupadi. As we saw before, Draupadi had one son of each Pandava, and there are five Draupadeyas, and they are also great warriors. And Saubhadraha Mahabahuhu. Saubhadraha means Subhadrayaha Putraha, who is Abhimanyuhu. And all of them, Mahabahuhu, Abhimanyu is known for his heroism. Therefore, he is also given a special title, Mahabahuhu, the man of powerful arm. And all of them, Shankan Prithak Prithak Dadmuhu, they blew their conches distinctly. Prithivipate is Sanjaya addressing Dhritarashtra. Remember, the whole thing is Sanjaya narrating in front of Dhritarashtra. And then what happened? Saghoshodhartarashtranam Hridaya Nivyadarayat Nabhascha Prithivim Chaiva Tumulo Vyanunadayan. So when all the Pandavas made the huge noise or huge sound, then this was heard by Duryodhana and other people. And hearing this sound, Duryodhana's heart was pierced, as it were. That is said here, Shankhanada, the huge Shankhanada of all the people, Vyadarayatu, literally Vyadarayatu means tore into pieces. It afflicted intensely. It pierced the heart of Dhartharashtras or Kauravas. That means already Duryodhana was frightened. Hearing this sound, his fear increased. And this fear increased because of his diffidence. And his diffidence is because of Adharma. So therefore, Vyasacharya indicates, and what type of Shankhanada it was? It was Nabhascha Prithivin Chaiva Anunadayan. Anunadaha means echoing, resounding, reverberating all over, on the earth and above in the sky. These Shankhanada spread, and it pierced the heart of Kauravas. Continuing, athavyavasthitan drishtva dhartarashtran kapidvajah pravritte shastra sampate dhanurudyamya pandavah Rishikesham tada vakyam
Rishikesham tada vakyam
Idamahamahipate
Idamahamahipate
So up to the 19th verse is the first phase. And now from the 20th verse, a turning point is going to take place. And the turning point is indicated by the word atha. In Sanskrit language, the word atha indicates a change, either in topic or a change in context. If it is a movie or a TV show, they can have some background music. Poor Vyasacharya cannot have any such thing, and therefore he has to only do it through a word. And therefore, he indicates the turning point by the word atha. Now, what is the present situation? Kauravas have blown the conches. Pandavas have blown the conches. That means, both the teams or both the armies have indicated that they are ready. Now that the indication is over, the actual battle must start. And therefore, shooting of the arrows must start. Therefore, Vyasacharya says, Shastra Sampate Pravritte. In fact, the situation was ready for the Shastra Sampata. Shastra Sampata means what? The release of the arrows. The shooting of the arrows, Pravritta. It is time is ideal ready. But at the nick of the moment, just like the bowlers running the bowling run, and then last moment, kai valikithu, kaal valikithu, shule, again they go back. It is the night, and then there is dew is there, and then second time, whoever is bowling, ava thootu poyidrana. Ellam sollindirukala illayo. So therefore, they are ready. But the last moment, some problem. Similarly, Arjuna has to shoot the arrows, but at the nick of the moment, a flash of thought comes in Arjuna's mind, and this flash is going to be a huge turning point. Because if this flash had not taken place, if both had started the Mahabharata war, Gita-upadesha would not have taken place, and Vyasacharya would not have written the Gita, and we would not have started the Gita classes, and you would not be sitting here. All this happened because of what? Atha. That Atha indicates why we are sitting here. And the flash indicate Pandrar, and what is the flash of thought? He feels, I should see the people who are arrayed in front. Somehow he feels, just before shooting the arrows, let me see who are the people whom I am going to destroy in the war. Perhaps this is the last moment that I am seeing them alive. And naturally, and Arjuna knows that they are all various relatives, because this is a family war, and therefore I will not be able to see their face. Nama farewell paakaroma illayo vayasaachi onnu oru nokku paathuttu vandudrom. Adu madri Arjuna feels that he should see their face, and therefore he orders Krishna, that is said here, dhartarashtran vyavasthitan drishtva. Arjuna saw all the Kauravas, Dhartarashtras means Kauravas. In fact, Dhartarashtras must be the real expression for Duryodhanadis. The word Kauravas is really speaking common to both Duryodhana family as well as the Pandavas. Really speaking, Arjuna is also Kaurava because literally Kaurava means those who belong to Kuru Vamsha. And both the Dharmaputra people as well as Duryodhana people both belong to Kuru Vamsha. And therefore, Kauravas is the common name for both Pandavas and Dhartarashtras. But by convention, when we say Kauravas, we think that only Duryodhana people. It's more a convention, but literally speaking, it is just like, you know, in schools and all, I don't know whether it is there, we have a convention. The teacher shona lady, sir shona male. Male instructor is called sar and female instructor is called teacher. And the teacher and the sound kattale no lady ada irukana adhu padam naanga chinna vaala irukradhe solluvom adhu teacher illa adhu sar aakum adhu sar illa teacher aakum illa male female division we make. It is a convention. We can have male teacher also. Female sir is not possible, but we can have male teachers also. Like that, we are used to the expression Kaurava means the Duryodhana people and Pandavas are not called, but really speaking, Kaurava is common name for both. If you have to differentiate, how should you differentiate? The Dharmaputra, etc. should be called Pandavas and Duryodhana, etc. must be called Dhartarashtraha. Dhartarashtraha means Dhritarashtra Putraha. Dhartarashtraha. Anala in that correct expression use Pandrikar Vyasar. Dhartarashtran Vyavasthitan Drishtva. Arjuna sees. And who is Arjuna? Kapidvajaha means the one who has got monkey emblem on his flag. And that monkey represents Anjaneya. And we all know that Anjaneya is Vayuputra, the son of Vayudevata. And we also know that Bhima is also Vayuputraha. Their father's father is the same for both, and therefore Bhima and Anjaneya are brothers. And Anjaneya is supposed to be a Chiranjeevi. And therefore he was there in Ramayana Kalam, Treta Yugam, Dwapara Yuga, Kali Yuga, he continued to exist. And therefore, Bhima made a special request to Anjaneya. And that request is, you should come to the Mahabharata battle and you should bless us so that we will get victory. And therefore, Anjaneya said, I will be in the form of an emblem, as it were, on your flag and I will bless you. And the people say that Anjaneya also had, therefore, an opportunity to listen to Gita. Avarkadur saurima poyitthu. Ramopadesamum avar kekarar, Krishnopadesamum kekarar. And they say, there is a commentary on the Gita written by Anjaneya. It's called Paishacha Bhashyam. Paishachana Pishachingra artham illainga. Here, Paishacha means the one who did not have a physical form. So, he existed in invisible form, heard the Gita and wrote a commentary. And that commentary is even now available. It's a beautiful, simple bhashyam called Hanumat Paishacha Bhashyam. Anyway, because of this reason, Arjuna got a name Kapidvajaha. So, the one who has got the monkey emblem in his flag, So Arjunaha drishtva hi sa. And what did he do? Dhanuhu udyamya. He raised his bow. Like the batsman doing, not ready. Raise panna umpire vandu stop gaadu. Cricket match nareya nadakkaradunala and the example sonne. So similarly, he also raises his bow saying, not ready, don't shoot now, not ready. So dhanuhu udyamya pandavaha kapidvajaha. What did he do? Hrishikesham idam vakyam aha. So there we saw Duryodhana went to Dronacharya, and here Arjuna is addressing whom? Hrishikesham, Lord Krishna. Idamaha Mahipate. Mahipate means King Dhritarashtra. Sanjaya is addressing Dhritarashtra as Mahipati. O King Dhritarashtra, this is what happened. And all these things, how does Sanjaya see? Satellite TV. Now, Sanjaya is not in the actual battlefield, but he was in the palace and he could see everything. Panda kalathile ella apdi paathara sonna nambala. Now you will. It is very easy to see. Because on the other side of the continent, whatever happens, we are now able to see. And Sanjaya's TV was better because he could even read the mind of the people. What is in batsman's mind or bowler's mind? Enna solra namakku theriyadu. But Sanjaya had an extraordinary TV that he could also read the mind. So therefore, during Vishwarupa Darshanam, what transpired in Arjuna's mind, even that Sanjaya report. And what did Arjuna say to Lord Krishna? Arjuna uvacha. Sena yorubhayor madhye. Ratham sthapaya mechuta. Yavadetan nirikshekham. Yodhukamana vasthitan. Kairmaya saha yodhavyam. Asmin rana samudyame. Yotsyamanana vekshekham. Yaye tetra samagataha. Dhartha rashtrasya durbuddhehe. Yuddhe priya chikirshavaha. So now comes Arjuna's words to Lord Krishna. So Arjunaha uvacha. He says, He Achyuta. So this is another beautiful name, epithet of Lord Krishna, Achyutaha. It's a very, very significant word, both religious significance, moral significance, philosophical significance. So Achyutaha means unfailing is one meaning. Infallible. So the one who never falls, the one who never fails is called Achyutaha. So whatever satya sankalpaha, whatever he wants to accomplish, he will accomplish because the Lord is omniscient and omnipotent. Therefore, he is called Achyutaha, never failing, because in Mahabharata war, they all trusted Lord Krishna and they found that their trust was proved worthy. Krishna helped them, kaivartakaha, kesavaha, he helped them. Similarly, here also we should understand that if we depend upon the local people and local institutions and local government, we may be successful or not. Samayathila kalavari uttuduva, kalavaradu solrom illayo. Whereas, if you depend upon the Lord, He is Achyutaha. And Draupadi experiences this in the Sabha of the Kaurava. All these people were powerful. 5 husbands were there. And each one powerful. And Bhishma, Drona, all these people were there. And when Draupadi was in crisis, she surrendered to all of them. And no help came. And then only when she surrendered to the Lord, help came. Therefore, the Lord is one who is always trustworthy. And therefore, He is given the title Achyutaha. And if you have to understand the philosophical significance, you have to go back to the Saturday class that we are seeing. As Param Brahma, the one who is Achyutaha, the one who is ever the infinite, the one who never falls into samsara. The Achyutaha means ever liberated, ever free, the one who never falls into samsara. And that is why when the Lord takes birth in the world, we don't call it janma, we call it avataraha. What is the difference between janma and avatara? Janma means falling down. Avatara means descending down. Namalela avataram chulamatam. Chulapudara. Ipunan thittra bodu chuluva. Avataram chuli adu chuluva. Adu vara meaning. But when we are born, it is falling down from our original nature. Therefore, it is samsara patanam. But when Bhagavan comes down as Krishna, Rama, it is called avataraha. The one who never falls. Then why should He come down? To uplift the humanity, He comes down. And since He never falls from His original nature, He is called Achyutaha. So one meaning is the one who is ever trustworthy. The second meaning is the one who is ever free, Nitya Muktaha. And that Achyuta, Ratham Sthapaya, Arjuna is commanding Lord Krishna. Because after all, Krishna is now a driver. Adukapra 11th chapter varudhu alapora. Hey Krishna, hey Parandhama, Paranjanma, allam solli avanukku minnala namaskaram, pinnadi namaskaram, right side la namaskaram. Idhukku chethi vachu panna porar. But ippa vandu, and aarukko Nahushanukku Indra pattam kadathu solladala. Adhu mari, so for some time, He is now the master. Therefore, hey Achyuta, Ratham Sthapaya, you please place the chariot Senayoho Ubhayoho Madhye, in between the two armies, because now the Kaurava army is a little bit far away, and because of the distance, I am not able to see their faces clearly. And I have not brought a binocular also, and therefore you please place the chariot in front. Ubhayoho madhye ratham sthapaya. For what purpose? Yava detan nirikshe aham. So that I can very clearly survey, see, yodhu kaman avasthitan. The people who have assembled there to fight with us. And kair maya saha yodhavyam. Let me clearly know with whom I have to fight yuddham kartavyam asmin rana samudyame, in this huge venture called Mahabharata war. Let me know with whom I have to fight. Yotsyamanan avekshaham yayetetra samagata. I want to have a clear view of them, and therefore you should take me in front of them. And not only I have to see the Duryodhana people, but also I have to see the other kings. Because remember, this Mahabharata war was some kind of a world war like, Because even though it was a war between only two families, so many other kings have joined this. Just like they had allies and axis, so many other kingdoms also, countries also are joining. Even from south also, they have said even Madura king and all those people also have joined. Some of them joined Pandavas, some of them joined Kauravas. And therefore, Arjuna says, let me also see the other kings who are supporting the Kauravas. So, Yuddhe Priyachikirshavaha. Let me see the allies of the Dhartarashtras. And when he is naming them Dhartarashtras, Arjuna's blood is boiling. Because they have done so many akramams, right from the Arakku Maligai onwards, consistently the Kauravas have been jealous of Pandavas and they were trying to destroy them several methods. And therefore, Arjuna feels extremely angry and therefore he uses the expression Durbuddhe. We have to note this expression. We will have to refer to this later also. It is a crucial expression. Durbuddhihi means dushta buddhihi, adharmika buddhihi. And why do I say this expression is very important? Because Arjuna does not see this as a war among the relatives or between the relatives. This is not an issue between who is the relative and what type of relationship we have. That is not the issue at all. But it is a fight between dharma and adharma. And who is the person we are not going to bother? Whoever is on the side of adharma, we have to destroy. No doubt, Bhishma is a great person, Drona is a great person, and they have brought Arjuna up, and not only that, they are even the gurus of Arjuna, and Arjuna did not have any sentimental problem, he did not have any emotional problem, his intellect was ruling his decision. Whoever has got a sound intellect, and whosoever emotional mind is under the control of intellect, he will have a right judgment. Only when the emotions and sentiments begin to overpower the buddhi, then all kinds of confusions will come. And until now, Arjuna did not have any emotional problem or sentimental problem, his intellect was very clear. What is that? That side is adharma side. And this side is dharma side. It is a fight between dharma and adharma. And in society, dharma is more important than temporary relationship. After all, human beings are subject to birth and death. Whereas dharma is shashvatam. And if we have to vote for one of these two, whether personal relationship or dharma, we should be clear enough in our thinking to choose dharma. That's why we have the story of the Manu Niti Cholan. The Chola Raja was there. And his own son had done adharma, and the Raja said that whether it is son or daughter, my relation or somebody else's relation, and no question. Whoever has done adharma, he has to be punished. Where dharma is given more importance than temporary relationship. Now also we have got politicians, we know what is happening. And Arjuna did not have this problem, and therefore here he says, Dhartarashtrasya Durbuddehe, showing that his intellect is now stronger than the mind. And Vedanta is going to later teach us emotions are wonderful. Because many people think that Vedantin will not have emotion. That aravadu kashtapattirukkarthe ellam brahmamayam solundu kalla mari ukkandirupanalli. No, Vedantin is not like a stone. He is not a sentimentless person. In fact, later Krishna will say, Jnani is the embodiment of compassion. Maitra karuna evacha. So, sentiments are wonderful. Emotions are wonderful. It is a unique gift from the Lord. But what Shastra says is, once the sentiments begin to cloud our intellect, then it becomes sentimentalism. And once the intellect is clouded, the biggest problem is our judgments will be wrong. We will begin to see dharma as adharma, adharma as dharma. Sentimentalism will lead to delusion. But sentiments make me a human being. And until now, Arjuna did not have the problem of sentimentalism, and therefore he happily came to the battlefield without any regrets or any compunction. Even though battle involves himsa, even though it involves killing his own kith and kin, Arjuna never felt bad, because if protection of dharma requires destruction, as a last resort, it can be taken to. Therefore, Arjuna did not have any problem until now. And that is indicated by the word durbuddhe. His thinking is very clear. But now we have to see the change. The moment he comes in front and he sees the people, and gradually his mind is going to change, and we are going to see that emotion is going to replace discrimination. Attachment is going to replace discrimination. And therefore samsara begins, and therefore Gita has to begin. How? In the next class we will see. Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.
Om Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya.